Hello, people. In this case, let us look at this case and we have to answer a few questions given here. Okay, first let us look at this case. They have given that there is a bank employee who is 45 year old. Let us give importance to the age, and he's a male, right, from middle class family. He's from a middle class family, presents with complaints of what? Polyuria, polydipsia, polyphagia, weight loss, and easy fatigability since 6 months. He has positive family history of diabetes 2 mellitus, type 2 diabetes mellitus in his father. His BMI is 32, obviously it is more, and his casual plasma glucose means what? Random plasma glucose is 335 milligram per deciliter, and his HbA1c is 10.2%. Looks high, everything looks high here. He is a fast food lover, he loves to eat junk food. He also complains of decreased vision, for which he has consulted an ophthalmologist. So very clear here, they are giving you a lot of clues: polyuria, polydipsia, polyphagia, and symptoms of diabetes mellitus, family history of type 2 diabetes mellitus. They are saying he is obese, he has high blood sugar, he has glycosylated hemoglobin levels are high, he has decreased vision, looks like diabetic retinopathy, right? See guys, look at this table, this is very important. So this table is WHO recommendations for diagnostic criteria for diabetes and intermediate hyperglycemia. Let's look at diabetes. That's what we are concerned for here. Fasting plasma glucose, if it is greater than 126 milligram per deciliter, and 2 hour plasma glucose, if it is greater than 200 milligram per deciliter, that is greater than 7 millimoles per liter or greater than 11 millimoles per liter. Okay, so this is what you have to remember for diabetes, right? Impaired and all is there. Impaired means if it is 110 to 125, it will be impaired. Anyways, we are directly going to diabetes level. If it is below this 126, but it is above 110, they are calling it as impaired. Okay. But here, remember, if it's above 200, definitely this guy has diabetes. When after giving him 75 gram of oral glucose, after 2 hours, you'll measure the plasma glucose. If it is greater than 200, definitely you will call it as diabetes. And if it is fasting glucose, if you will see more than 126 milligram per deciliter, then definitely he has diabetes. Okay. Here they are saying it is casual plasma glucose is greater than 335 milligram per deciliter. This is more like random, isn't it? Look at BMI, guys. See, BMI 18.5 to 25, nearly 25, that is fine. That is normal. 18.5 to 25 is normal. But this guy is what, 30 something? So he's 32. Let's look at this. If he's 32, he's coming under obese class 1. So his risk factors to comorbidities is moderate. He has moderate risk factor to comorbidities. Okay, he's obese class 1. What about HbA1c? So this is glycosylated hemoglobin. So if you have it below something, it will be normal. After that, it will become pre-diabetes, diabetes, etc. That is 6.5, above 6.5 if it is. Okay. So this person has really high, what do you say? 10, right? So he has more than 6.5. See, his random blood sugar is coming to 335 milligram per deciliter. So random should act, if it is greater than 200 milligram percentage, you can take it as diabetes. Okay. So you know all the diabetes cutoffs, right? 126, 2 hour plasma glucose 200, random greater than 200. So this HbA1c, right? It is a value that doesn't get affected by exercising, fasting, etc. And they are saying if you multiply this by 25, it will give you the sugar level. Let's check that. So if you multiply it by 25, you'll get 250 something. Actually, we will get only 255, but here it's 335. Okay. Actually, average blood sugar you will get by multiplying this by 25. Yes. So now we are moving on. Actual questions. What is your diagnosis? Yes, it is diabetes mellitus. Now, can you say it is type 1 or type 2? It's type 2 diabetes mellitus. Why? That also we will come to. But it is diabetes, we have confirmed that. What are the other investigations you need to confirm diagnosis? What is the procedure for the test? What level of prevention has failed? How do you advise him to get eye checkup? What will be your advice for newly diagnosed health problem and preventive measure? Okay, let's look at this. What is your diagnosis, guys? Diabetes. Okay, in diabetes there's type 1 and type 2. This is type 2 diabetes mellitus. He has family history of diabetes in his father. His BMI is indicating insulin resistance, they are saying. And random blood sugar is greater than 200, which is bad. HbA1c is greater than 6.5, which is bad. Then Other signs that you should look for, they are saying you can look for acanthosis nigricans and skin tags which are associated with insulin resistance. What other test you will do, they are asking, because in the question they have given us only random blood sugar. So what you do is fasting plasma sugar and oral glucose tolerance test. How will you do that? Fasting plasma sugar in the morning, you can ask him to come without eating for 8 hours, right? And then you check if it is greater than 126 milligram per deciliter, you can see that he has diabetes. Or oral glucose tolerance test, you give him 75 gram of oral glucose and after 2 hours, you'll measure his glucose. If it is greater than 200 milligram per deciliter, he has diabetes. So these are the two tests you'll ask him to do extra. What is the procedure for OGTT? After overnight fasting, you will do the, first when he comes, you will do the fasting plasma sugar. Then you will give him 75 grams of anhydrous glucose in 250 ml of water. Remember, just take quarter liter water and add 75 gram of anhydrous glucose and ask him to take it over 5 minutes. Don't gulp it down. Over 5 minutes, you take it. Then you take blood sample at 2 hours and measure the blood sugar level. If it is greater than 200 milligram per deciliter, or 11 millimoles, and it is confirmatory for diabetes mellitus. So which level of prevention has failed? So what and all levels you have? Primordial, primary, secondary and tertiary. So primordial has failed. He had risk factors already. His parents have a family history. Then he himself is obese, right? What else did we see? Did we see obesity? Yes, BMI, yes. Then what about primary? Yes, primary has failed. He already developed diabetes mellitus. Secondary, what do you think? Secondary has failed. Secondary, how will you prevent? Early diagnosis and treatment. Is it early? Is it early diagnosis and treatment? No, it is not early diagnosis and treatment. He has already gone into eye problems. So a diabetic retinopathy. So early diagnosis and treatment, secondary prevention also has failed. What about tertiary? So yes, primary has failed. Now secondary has failed. Now tertiary, he's already there in eye problem. So you want to limit the disability and you want to rehabilitate him. Is it possible? It could be possible. What do you say? I would say tertiary prevention we have to do. But disability probably slightly has already occurred, right? Okay, I would say tertiary, some amount you can still help him. Let us look at the other complications. Look at this, what they have written here. Other complications, coronary artery disease, peripheral vascular disease, diabetic retinopathy. This is the problem this guy is having. He's having retinopathy already. So if retinopathy changes have already occurred, he has to get his eye checked every 6 months. If it was before that, before he got retinopathy, then once a year would have been enough. But this guy has already gone into diabetic retinopathy. So retina changes have occurred. So he needs to go in for every 6 months eye checkup. Okay. Then diabetic nephropathy, diabetic neuropathy. Remember, retinopathy, nephropathy, neuropathy. Okay. That is why I'm saying some amount of tertiary prevention is still there, because this may have occurred, but at least the other things we can protect. What do you say? Actually, if you see complications, the way you have to write it are microvascular complications and macrovascular complications. Microvascular, you have like retinopathy, neuropathy and nephropathy, and macrovascular, you have coronary artery disease, peripheral artery disease, stroke, etc. So microvascular complications are directly proportional to the glycosylated hemoglobin levels. Okay, you can reduce the incidence of these complications with the glucose control, retinopathy, nephropathy, neuropathy. So here they are talking about chronic kidney disease, okay, nephropathy. Macrovascular, what and all will be there, you have to control blood pressure, right? Else these people can go into coronary artery disease like myocardial infarction, angina, they can get gangrene, right? Peripheral vascular disease, they can have stroke. Stroke means to say that part of brain did not get blood supply properly. So what were the questions they've asked us in this case study? Let us look at the questions again and answer them. What is your diagnosis, investigations to confirm, level of prevention, eye checkup? What will be your advice for the newly diagnosed health problem and preventive measures that he should follow? Okay, so that's coming to more like tertiary prevention, how you will do. Let's look at it. So inform the patient that this is a lifelong disease, but he can prevent the complications by having preventive measures like dietary modifications. He has to eat green leafy vegetables such as spinach, fenugreek, mint, vegetables such as cabbage, cauliflower, tomatoes, cucumber, etc. He should not have high calorie diet like junk foods. Did it say in this case that he likes to eat junk foods? He usually eats junk foods. He's a fast food lover. Yeah. So the question itself has all those points that you can write, right? And he should have a balanced diet. He should not have, he can replace rice with chapati and ragi balls. Okay. So what and all did they tell here? Green leafy vegetables. So green leafy vegetables, spinach, cabbage, cauliflower, mint. What did they say? Mint, mint, fenugreek, extra. Avoid high calorie, balanced diet. Rice should avoid. Can have chapati, ragi balls, etc. Eat some low sugar fruits like apples, oranges, banana. This is normally what we eat, isn't it? We eat apples, banana, oranges. This is normally what we eat, guava, etc. Then include soya bean, oats, etc. in your food. Then medications, anti-diabetic drugs should be given. They have not given the list here, anti-diabetic drugs. Then we'll come to that. Then lifestyle modifications, he should have some moderate intensity aerobic physical activity with nice air, right? Aerobic physical activity, moderate intensity. Or he can do vigorous intensity, short duration of exercise. Okay, then at work, he should stretch his arms and legs. He should do yoga, meditation, etc. Then what are they saying? Physical activity. Okay. See, these people can have loss of sensation, right? So their feet should be examined for any defective blood circulation, sensation, etc. And you should tell them to have self-care in diabetes. You should make sure that you don't prick yourself, hurt yourself, because you will have bleeding tendency and you will also hurt yourself, not feel the pain, etc. Gangrene, etc. can develop. So you have to monitor your blood sugar every 3 months, the HbA1c. Okay, then if there are other family members, you can screen them. Remember, this is type 2 diabetes mellitus, right? So here the diet control is very important. You should tell him to exercise. That's also very important. This exercise will increase his GLUT, right? Glucose transporter. So when he exercises, all the glucose will enter his muscles. Then you have to give him diabetic drugs. What are those? So the drugs that they actually give are, they give biguanides, okay? These are oral drugs they are giving. They are not giving any insulin here because these people are insulin resistant. So here they are talking about biguanides, metformin, linagliptin, glipizide and tolbutamide. Let's look at this. So tolbutamide is here, sulfonuria. Tolbutamide enhance the insulin secretion, is it? Interesting. Glipizide. Then they are talking about metformin, biguanide to overcome insulin resistance. They are giving overcome the insulin resistance and giving insulin secretion increasing. Tolbutamine, glipizide, which is the other one? L something, right? Lee something. Linagliptin, is it this one? Yes, it is linagliptin. So let's just go here. Linagliptin is here. It is a dipeptidyl peptidase. So did you understand what and all drugs they are recommending for type 2 diabetes mellitus? Metformin, linagliptin, tolbutamide, glipizide. Okay. There's an additional point that metformin should not be given if there is nephropathy. Kidney should be perfect. See, remember oral hypoglycemic drugs, what will be the side effects? The main thing they will be is it will cause hypoglycemia. So in this question, we looked at a 45-year-old male who has polyuria, polydipsia, polyphagia. He's urinating more. He has dipsia is what he's drinking, a lot of water. He has a lot of appetite. Polyphagia, he's eating a lot. Weight loss is important. Polyphagia is not very specific, but you can remember if you want. Polyuria, polydipsia, weight loss. Remember, he has lost weight. Though he has lost weight, his BMI is 32. Wow. He has easy fatigability. Okay, so the decreased vision. So we had to answer a few questions. Did we answer diagnosis, investigations, procedure of the test? Also, we told you 75 gram glucose in 250 ml of water. Once you take the fasting plasma sugar level, then you ask him to take this. And then after giving this, wait for 2 hours, take the blood and check for the glucose. Level of prevention, we feel primary and secondary have failed. Tertiary still can be prevented. Then health problem, what will your advice be? Tell this guy to diet, exercise, right? Preventive measures, all that we told you, same thing. Basically, he has to wear some chappal, right? Self microcellular rubber footwear, MCR, right? This is MCR footwear. So, what else do you feel here? MCR footwear. Self-care and diabetes, there are some things we'll take. Self-care means, you know, they should not cut their nails very deep. Right, they should not they should not hurt themselves because it will not heal, etc. And they should also monitor their blood pressure. They should control. Okay, then what else? That's it, right? We'll only add some points here and write. Okay, yes, this is also a non-communicable disease. So the national program will be what? National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Diseases and Stroke, right? So the D in this program is diabetes, National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Diseases and Stroke. Remember, okay? They're all jumping and catching something. So four things they're catching. So you can remember. Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Disease and Stroke. This is the National Program for Prevention, NPCDCS. That's all for now in this video. Bye-bye.